Hey, what's going on, Cancers? Butch Tarot here. I'm going to do the rest of February read. It is a general read, so it may not resonate with everyone. It is for your sun, moon, rising, and your Venus. For all you cross watchers, roles can be reversed. Always feel free to comment down below. If you like this video, feel free to give me a thumbs up. I appreciate it. If you haven't already, and you know, you want to be part of a great community, subscribe. You know, I always see great conversations going on in the comments. We're all about the love on this channel. You know, upwards and onwards. With all that being said, let's get it. Cancers. So the first thing I have, Cancers, is this energy that's coming in around you. This is somebody that you already know. This is someone that you have a history with. Now, I do feel like the true potential of this connection was never reached. I feel like this person that you're dealing with, there's a lot of love between the two of you. I feel like with them, I feel like you gave them a lot of love and all you expected back was the same. And I feel like they never really showed up for you. You know, I feel like you showed them a lot of love and I feel like that scared the shit out of them. I'm going to be completely honest with you, you know, because not only did you share love with them, but you made them feel things that they weren't ready to feel. And I feel like we have the shadow side, which is the devil card. I feel like this person there's some issues that this person has been dealing with. And this is something, I feel like it's rooted very deeply in this person. This is not from a past relationship so much, you know, that could play a part in it, but that's not all. I mean, I feel like this person has trust issues. I feel like they have, you know, commitment issues because I feel like every time they showed up for someone, every time they felt love for someone, that person ended up hurting them or misusing their trust. And like I said, I don't feel like it's just past romantic relationships. I feel like this goes very deep. This could be a family member that hurt them or a friend, someone that they've known a long time, someone that they trusted. And that's why they have these trust issues. They have a hard time trusting their feelings because when they feel something, and I'm going to tell you something that I see in the cards, and we're going to go into it a lot deeper. But the first thing I see is this person had a hard time taking that leap of faith because of those trust issues. They wanted to. You know, very badly they wanted to. But it's not that they couldn't trust you. They don't trust themselves. Like I said, anytime they became vulnerable, they got hurt. So they put this big-ass wall up around their heart. And I'm telling you, you were chipping away at it, and you were chipping away fast, and that scared them. You know, and I feel like that's when the things started to fall apart. You know, I do feel a lot of self-sabotaging energy. You know, I feel like this person couldn't be honest with you, but not, it wasn't malicious. They were afraid to be open. They were afraid to be vulnerable because that's when they get hurt. And the connection they felt with you was like no other they've ever felt. So that scared them even more, because they were falling hard and fast and they couldn't stop themselves. So the best thing they could do, like I said, was that self-sabotaging energy. They started to sabotage this. They started to, you know, push you away. You know, they couldn't accept your love. Now, with this person, I feel like this person, that's how it was. Now moving forward, I feel a lot of anxiety in this person, a lot of late nights not being able to sleep, you know, and a lot of that is due to the regret. I mean, they miss you. They miss you more than you could ever know. I feel like this person only thinks about you. They've never let you go. You know, they're only thinking about you. They're only thinking about that one cup. You know, and this was something real. But they weren't ready for it. They weren't ready at all. But matter whether or not they were ready for it or not, they're not walking away from this. They have never walked away from this. Now, inadvertently, I feel like it's all about perspective. You know, I feel like this person needed this. They needed that push. They needed someone that could love them with that unconditional love. They needed someone that, even though they pushed them away, they were still there. And I feel like you've still been there for that person. And that's what's really making this person see things that they never seen before. And I do feel like this person is starting to see things in that different perspective. You know, they're starting to realize that all those people that should have loved them that didn't, all those people that mistreated them, it's because they weren't the right person. It's not about you. When you get hurt by someone, it's not about you. It's about the person that hurt you. It's the issues they deal with. This person, all they wanted was love. And every time they loved, they got hurt. And then when they, you know, when they felt that love from you, like I said, it scared them. They were seeing the negatives instead of the positives. But moving forward, like I said, I feel like this person's finally being able to emotionally grow. And I feel like you did that for them. Inadvertently, you healed this person, and they will never forget that. And they feel that regret, and they feel that anxiety, they feel that late night not being able to sleep because they know they screwed up. They know they're missing out. And like I said, all they needed was that unconditional love, and you gave it to them. And they're seeing that for what it is. And like I said, this person, I do feel like this person is coming back, and they're coming back in a big way, Cancer. And they are gonna put in a lot of work. They're going to put in the work because they know that you deserve it. They know that they deserve this. You know, we accept the love that we think we deserve. And that's what I feel like this person had been doing for a long time in their life. I feel like they accepted love because they accepted some half-assed love for some people. Or they accepted being treated the way they were treated because they thought that that's what they deserve. But you show them that they deserve more, and they'll never forget that. You know, I do see that communication open up, and I do see this person finally, they finally are starting to heal. And with that healing comes a huge transformation. We have that Scorpio energy with that death card, that huge transformation. You know, I feel like you made this person stronger. And in turn, when they come back, when they, you know, that reconciliation that they're looking for, that's going to make you stronger together. Because we also have the Lover's card. You know, very soulmate, twin flame type of energy. I feel like this was, like I said, you hadn't seen the full potential of this, but you will see it. Because like I said, this person is not willing to go without a fight. They will fight for you. They will put in the work. They will show up for you. They're finally ready to nurture this. And like I said, when this person comes towards you, they're going to be stronger. And it's going to make you stronger together. Give you balance. That equilibrium, that temperance. And like I said, when they come towards you and they start opening that communication, I feel like there's going to be a very high amount of truth coming from this person. And I feel like they're going to do whatever it takes to make it right. Because like I said, I don't feel like they were listening to their intuition. And I feel like that, you know, there was some self-confident issues. They felt like they couldn't be loved. And when someone loves someone, you know, they start to think, overthink it in their head. When you start giving somebody a lot of love that's not used to getting it, they start to overthink that shit in their head. They're like, what do they want? What, you know, especially when they've been mistreated by people in the past, they start to wonder, what's this person's ulterior motives, maybe. You know, and instead of just accepting the love, they have to look into it deeply because they've been hurt by other people. When you get hurt by people in your past, and especially when at a young age, you start to think that everybody's out to hurt you. You know, you become very, you know, very skeptical of anybody that comes towards you and anybody that shows you love. But like I said, this person is seeing things in a different perspective. That anxiety, that feeling of regret, it won't go away. It's eating at them, and that's why they're returning, and that's why they've grown. You know, and I do see them wanting to build a foundation with you. They want to build a future. And like I said, they're coming back for that reconciliation. They want to make things right because, like I said, they can't stop thinking about you. And at the end of the day, I feel like in the perspective that they're looking at is the fact that, you know, even when they were pushing you away, you were still willing to love them. You were still trying to be with them. You were still trying to help them. And it wasn't you that screwed this up. It was them. You know, like I said, when you get hurt, it's hard for your heart to heal, you know. And the more you get hurt, the more, you know, damage it takes. It's almost like being in a car, and the more accidents you get in, the more vulnerable your car becomes. If you keep driving the same car, you get in accidents, you keep fixing it, but there's still vulnerabilities there. You know, and it's almost like you're moving forward, you're driving 20 just because you want to drive extra slow so you don't have to worry about hitting anybody or anybody hitting you. You know, you stay off the highway. They needed someone like you. And like I said, that soulmate, that twin flame energy. I mean, you were meant to find each other. They were just a little slow. They got a little lost. Now they're catching up. And I'm not going to say, I mean, there's a huge transformation. This person seeing things with a different perspective. And I'm not saying there's not going to be some rough, you know, rough, bumpy road ahead. But I feel like the worst is behind you. Now with this person, we have Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. We have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We have some Capricorn as well. And I don't feel like you gave up on this person, Cancer. I feel like there's a reason why you never gave up. You know, that's what unconditional love is. I mean, sometimes we gotta love people even if they don't love themselves. And, you know, sometimes they need time to catch up. And that's what this person needed. They needed that time to catch up. They got a little lost. You know, the road to get to you was not easy. That's what I have for you. Be good. Take care. Stay safe.